Hello, Cool Kid again, with the second part in my Lego City. Here we'll be doing the restaurant, the museum, and if we have time, the tunnel. There is actually stuff inside of it. And then in the next video after this, we'll be doing the train track when I'm finished with the train. Now I will start with a museum or restaurant. I'll do it again in the order that I made them, so museum will be first. I shall get off the roof. I'll actually probably cut it only like 30 seconds in. Oh. Okay, I'm back. I got off the roof. Yeah, unlike the other ones, this roof is actually made to be removable, where it's all like flat pieces. So this museum is mainly is for dinosaurs and Egyptian hieroglyphs, because a lot of my tin pieces had those on it, and I do not have many tin pieces, so to build this I had to use those. Well, sorry, the front, I used Jurassic World, lots of minifigs, and the dinosaurs from Jurassic World, so I used the ACU from Jurassic World as the bodyguards, I guess, or just guards in general at the front of the museum. Nice arches for decoration, and a little squiggly thingy right there. I don't know what it's for, but it's just, I guess, a little thing, and one moment. And then we'll move on to the inside. We have the Velociraptor bit with a little plaque. And the reason there's a plaque with an arrow pointing up is because there is a pterodactyl, but I stick it on the roof, and the roof is off right now. I'll show you that when it's closed. And then we have the T-Rex with a little plaque. I actually put in, I put in Owen, Claire, and Gray, I think is his name. I might forget. Yeah, I used pieces to put the plates at an angle. There's also the Dilophosaurus exhibit. We have another Jurassic World guy. I can't remember what his name is. Showing a little kid the Dilophosaurus. Not the little plaque. The plaques don't have words on them because I didn't bother to put words on them. We have a guy walking, I guess, just towards the trash can over there. And probably my favorite bit, we have a caution wet sign with a janitor, I guess just another Jurassic World guy, mopping up a little puddle which a guy has slipped in. And he is, yeah, kind of like cartoon slip. The way he flies up in the air. And then over here we have another little bodyguard, I guess, looking over there at something. Where we have a whole, like, separate tiny little room. Which we have Simon Hazarani. Don't quote me on that. I think that's the name of him. And, something, I can't remember his name, I think it was like Hoskins or something, but I can't remember his name. Anyway, that is kind of it for the museum. It's not super detailed, but it is, I think it's good. I will get the roof back on now. Okay, back with the roof on. Back with the roof on. And I will be showing you the inside now. Kind of, it is pretty dark, but you can see that the pterodactyl is just hanging on the roof. Over here, we have the big sign, big brick-built sign that says museum. That's probably it for the museum. Moving on to the restaurant. I went to London, and the souvenirs I got was a London bus and a beef eater. And so we have the beef eater just standing outside the door, I guess, is saying, oh, come on in. We have the brick-built sign restaurant, probably my least favorite brick-built sign because it just kind of looks weird. The big London bus. We have lots of windows. These windows are kind of sticking out from the wall a bit. There's the windows. It comes up a bit, and the doorway is actually a little bit out because everything here is attached in some way to it. Like with there, it's the little tiles. And with here, it is the doorway. And that's pretty much it for the outside. The outside is not super detailed, but now I will show you the inside when I get the roof off again. Okay, I'm back. I got the roof on. Now I can show you the interior. We have lots of little tables with people sitting. I hear someone have food. This guy's got a carrot and a bit of lettuce or something. Person's got a pie. Person over there has a chicken leg. And those three people have not gotten food yet. This person has apple and carrot. And we have a little cash register right there with a little computer, and it is one of those little safe pieces where you can slide the money in. There is a couple bit of money in there. And that's kind of it for the seating area. It's not super detailed, as I said. We have the little door into the cooking area. There are a couple windows so you can actually see into it. I guess so. You can see you have a little cutting board, a couple cabinets. I guess he's frying some vegetables with a little vegetable holder over there. He's got a knife. The chef, there's a little sink, I guess, for washing your hands or washing the food. There's a carrot, I guess, that flipped under all these shelves. We have an apple, a bit of lettuce, banana, pie, another apple, a pretzel. I believe that's a chicken leg down there. You can't see it that well, though. And that would be it for the little shelves. The two little windows, they do open and close. I'll show you that in a second. These little ones, they just never. There we go. Wait, I got it. See, they just open up just to let out steam. And that's kind of it for the restaurant. Well, I will see you when I get the roof back on. Okay, got the roof back on. And I think I will have time to go over the tunnel. So there's one last look at the city. That's probably the last one. Maybe you'll see it again. But anyway. Over to the tunnel. I used a blanket held up by a couple things. A stool. And a couple big Lego pillars. Pillars made out of Lego. I'll start at the front and then at the back. We have the first little mining bit. There's lots of gold and stuff around. There's a guy with two bags and a little satchel, I guess. I guess he carries all the gold. I used two Santa beards, one backwards, one forwards, to make kind of a all-the-way-around hair. There's a guy about to hammer on some gold to get it out. Yep, it's a little mining operation, as you can see. And right there, we have a guy who's in the middle of the track, kind of drilling at some stuff. The train actually does go through this without bumping anything, in case you were wondering. And over there's actually one across the whole thing. There's another guy with some dynamite and a shovel digging away at a piece of rock. And here we have probably the biggest one with the most. Okay, I think I'm gonna take it out for you to see it well enough, because it's kind of difficult to see in there unless you have a very good vantage point. Anyway, got it out. There you go. There's a couple guys, one's mining, one's looking through a magnifying glass made of a frying pan and a clear piece looking at a crystal. He's got a backpack but a little thing with holding some stuff. There's like a few diamonds and stuff stuck around it, lots of gold. Guys mining, drilling away. And we have a couple lava monsters, I guess, watching them. This guy can't see it because he's looking at the magnifying glass, and this guy's kind of hidden behind the rock. This one's a keychain, actually. Can't even tell. And that's kind of it for the mining operation. Because, yeah, I did use the rock monsters. Those are old. Those are pretty old things from back when power miners was a thing. It is not anymore, unfortunately. I like that. It was a good series. I didn't get any stuff from it because I was not. That is it for the tunnel. I'll give you one look at it from there. The train just go all the way through. And that's kind of it for the tunnel. Well, it is it for the tunnel. I don't know why I keep saying kind of it. Anyway, that's kind of your last look at the city for now. Because I'll probably do some more like things. I'm planning to do like a beach with a little island, with a little small lake and an island in the center. And maybe over there some housing. And a little park. But until then, I will see you in the next video for the train section. Goodbye.